here we are, Christmas of 1995. There's a picture of the top of the refrigerator. We'll zoom in on it. There we've got all of the little nested figures. On the front, we've got different things from the kids. And there's Mama dashing back and forth. Up on the top, we've got Christmas plates at different places, although they change from year to year. But in the windows here, we've got Santa Clauses and reflected figures. You can see the snow outside. We'll stack this all in one box. We've got various little knickknacks that are hard to see because it's against the light. Ming-Ling Sorensen. Can you say something, Ming-Ling Sorensen? Look up. Ming-Ling. Well, I guess we're not going to look up and say anything. Area. We've got on the top shelf these various Santa Clauses. Going down to the bottom shelf, more of the same. Again, it's hard to see because we're shooting against the lights. But Pat's little tree on the dining area here, along with the big Christmas candles and the Christmas mats for the table to eat off of. Here are the centerpiece that Etta gave us, along with the nice tablecloth, bright red, and some of the ornaments we've taken off of the light plates. Here's our chimney with nutcrackers up on top. Stockings hanging all around the bottom. And the stockings again. Looking at the Santa Clauses that are on the top of the fireplace. You see the nutcrackers along the bottom. Panning over, and this is the Christmas wish chair and the Santa bear. Here's the pine cones that have been with us for a number of years. Giant wreath that was given to us by Mrs. Lindstrom. Second little Christmas tree and the ornaments that we put on top of the buffet. This is the little tree with the MGs on it, which we've got sitting on the table. That's especially colorful and reminds us of our nice trips to Hawaii. Our big Christmas tree. It's beautiful, and maybe you can hear Ming-Ling complaining now, but at any rate, the big Christmas tree is festooned again with all the wonderful ornaments we've collected over the years, and one of the things that we enjoy doing during this season are all of the our addition this year of a Santa Claus that plays and plays and plays. Continuing on around the tree, more nutcrackers. This is our Christmas poinsettia for the year, and various ornaments that we put up on the walls there. Sweeping across the window here, we probably won't shelf. We have the crèche, which is the honored position. And then below that, we just left all of the hubbles in place. Season's greetings, plus the beautiful Father Christmas doll that Barbara made and gave to Pat a number of years ago. We see the nutcracker that Pat gave me this year, which is an aviator. And then we sweep up the Santa Claus tree, which is one of our annual trees that we enjoy decorating so much. It's hard to hang things on that tree, but somehow we manage. Yeah, east side of the chimney, there we have the Santa Claus. And we're looking through the window, looking at the icicles that there are on the balcony. All along the balcony, there are these icicles. Then we look up into the trees, and we see, again, the same, I can get the light in there. See the same shimmering ice that encompasses all of the branches of the trees. This is the great ice storm of 1996, January 18th, 17th and 18th on Dane's birthday. The damage was tremendous. Our house was without power for 14 hours. Mom and I were pretty cold and concerned. We went up to Barb and Neil's and stayed there. Lake, and you can see the icicles that formed. It started out, it was cold, but the rain was warm, and it settled all over everything, so there are inches of ice on all the sidewalks. A lot of trees broke off, and
the ice on the front little trees that stand the evergreens in front of the house. And then you can see going up into the bigger trees and on the vines how great the amount of ice is here. Beautiful tree across the street that's all ice. I'll focus in on it so you can see just exactly how covered with ice it was. Looking towards the Bears, you can see the top of that ice-covered tree. As we come back towards the ground and then pan out over the lake, and these are the evergreens right beside the house going up. Some of the debris as we walk along, these are branches that have been knocked down. That's snow crunching, as you can hear the frozen crust breaking under my feet. We look up at that wonderful, spectacular, ice-covered group of trees. They're right down by the lake. And marvel at the strength that God builds into trees and all of the parts of nature who live through this type of punishment of wind, rain, and ice. How glorious. Look at the beauty of this evergreen here. As I focus in, how lovely they are. Each and every needle covered with ice. House on the lakeside. I don't know if you can see the icicles that I took from inside or not, I don't believe so.
Well, start fighting. Come on, Boots, do something. Oh, okay, you're gonna wash now? Okay, are you gonna chase your sister? There. You're just gonna sit there and be pretty, huh? Oh, there we go. There we go. Big fight going on. Yeah. Hi, Boots. Where's your buddy?
Are you pooped? Yo-yo. Oh boy, somebody gonna jump.
This is a picture of the B-24 model that was given to me by the 489th Bomb Group. This is carved out of mahogany, all one piece except for the propellers. It's an exquisite piece of artwork, and the colors are true to the bomb group that I flew with, the 489th Bomb Division. Side view of the same airplane, and you'll note there that it's got the tail marking plus J, which was one of the tail markings of the combat airplanes that we flew. Front view of the airplane, you'll notice how graceful the wing is. It's a Davis wing, which was far more efficient than the wings on the B-17. The body was a bit shorter than the B-17, but we could carry a larger bomb load, and in addition to the larger bomb load, we could fly faster. They could, however, with their higher wing areas, fly higher, which was an advantage when there was a great deal of flak. Hey, Boots, look up here. Yeah, is that you? What are you going to do now, huh?
There, you get a better kid.
Hey, Boots. There. Good boy. Yeah, where's your sister? She on the table? There
here
she comes. Here comes Yo-Yo.
Well, that's a good picture.
Hey, Yo-Yo. Yo-Yo.
Come on, babies. Over here. You're not hungry, are you? No.
Sometimes we rest, but not very often, do we? Here they are, cuddling down. One of them looks like he's ready to fall off the edge, but he'll straighten himself out. That's Boots. He's the funny one. He's the most lovable of the two. Yo-Yo is a typical little for a female. She decides one day she won't eat, and the next day she eats like a horse. But anyhow, Boots is kind of a ragamuffin. He likes everybody and he chews on everything. Tries to climb without any claws. And there they are now, they're resting. Pretty soon there'll be another storm.
Yeah, you know what that is.
That's old Boots. He knows the smart thing to do.
How are you doing, Boots?
Yo-Yo, come on and have a sunspot.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice. Now he's chasing it.
Yo-Yo.
Last night he was sitting in front of the TV trying to catch the baseball. Here you are, Mink. Little old Boots. Yeah. What happened to your sister, huh?
Here she comes.
Oh. Hi. So you came up here to visit me, did you? This is Yo-Yo. Yeah. Well, if you clean off the table later, I'll take some pictures of your Halloween decorations. We're sitting in here just before lunch enjoying the kids. Hi, Yo-Yo. Yo-Yo. That's a girl. Oh, aren't you a cutie, though? Yeah. You're a little beauty. Hey, Yo-Yo.